scene script. Have you ever wondered how aluminum foil is made? But before we get there, let's take a quick trip back to its humble beginnings. Picture yourself at the start of the 20th century. The year is 1903, and a shiny, flexible new material has just been produced, aluminum foil. This lightweight, versatile material was about to make a significant impact. Fast forward 8 years to 1911, when the first notable usage of aluminum foil emerged. Here's where the story gets a little sweet. Nestled away in Switzerland, the toddler tone chocolate bars were looking for a way to extend their shelf life and enable longer distance transportation. Enter aluminum foil. With its ability to provide a barrier against light, oxygen, and moisture, it was the perfect solution. Wrapped in this shiny new material, the chocolate bars could now travel further, reaching more people while still maintaining their freshness and quality. This was a game changer. Not only did aluminum foil prove its worth in preserving the quality of food items, but it also demonstrated its potential for broader applications. This initial use set the stage for the myriad of ways we utilize aluminum foil today. From wrapping our sandwiches to sealing off windows in science experiments, the uses of this versatile material have only expanded since its invention. Aluminum foil's journey from its first production to its first significant use illustrates its potential and versatility. It has proved itself to be a material of the future, even back in the early 1900s. Today, we might take this shiny, flexible material for granted. But its history reminds us of its valuable contributions to various industries and everyday life. So, that's a brief look at how aluminum foil made its debut in the world. Now, let's see how much we rely on it today. Today, aluminum foil has found its place in numerous applications worldwide. From the cozy corners of our kitchens to the vast expanse of industrial usage, this shiny, flexible material has become an indispensable part of our lives. It protects our food, enhances our cooking, and even helps in scientific research and technological advancements. You might be surprised to know that every year, we use approximately 5 million tons of aluminum foil globally. That's enough to circle the Earth about 125 times. It's used in packaging, insulation, electromagnetic shielding, and so much more. In the food industry alone, aluminum foil has revolutionized the way we store, cook, and serve food. It's used in baking, grilling, roasting, and even in preserving food freshness. Its versatility has made it a preferred choice for both households and industries. Aluminum foil has indeed become a household and industrial staple. But how does it get from bauxite to our kitchens? Let's find out. The journey of aluminum foil starts with bauxite, a mineral rich in aluminum oxides. This raw material, found in abundance across the globe, is the first step in a fascinating process that transforms bauxite into the everyday product we know as aluminum foil. To unlock the aluminum from bauxite, the mineral undergoes a chemical process called bauerization. Named after its inventor, Carl Bayer, this involves crushing the bauxite and mixing it with sodium hydroxide, a strong alkali. This mixture is then heated under pressure, resulting in a solution that's rich in aluminate and other impurities. But we're not there just yet. This solution then needs to be filtered and purified. This is done through a series of sedimentation, decantation, and filtration processes, which remove the impurities and leave us with a purified solution of aluminate. Now, the next stage is to extract pure alumina, or aluminum oxide, from this solution. To do this, the aluminate solution is cooled and seeded with crystals of alumina. These seeds trigger the alumina in the solution to crystallize out, leaving us with a pure white product known as alumina. But we're not done yet. To convert this alumina into aluminum, we need to use a process called electrolysis. In this process, the alumina is dissolved in an electronic bath, where a powerful electric current separates the pure aluminum from the oxygen in the alumina. The aluminum is then deposited on the cathode, a negatively charged electrode, where it can be collected. So, from bauxite, we get pure aluminum. But how does it become the thin, flexible sheet we know as aluminum foil? Let's delve into that next. The transformation of pure aluminum into foil is a meticulous process. Let's dive into this fascinating journey, where a solid block of aluminum transforms into a thin, flexible sheet we know as aluminum foil. the journey begins with pure aluminum being collected and cast into large blocks known as billets or ingots. These ingots are the raw material for the aluminum foil. But at this stage, they're still far too thick and rigid to be of any practical use in our kitchens or industrial applications. To transform these ingots into a usable form, they must undergo a process known as rolling. This is where the magic truly begins. The ingots are heated to very high temperatures, which increases their malleability, making them easier to shape and mold. This is a critical step because aluminum, like most metals, becomes more pliable when heated. Once the ingots are sufficiently heated, they are passed through a series of rollers in a process known as hot rolling. The pressure exerted by these rollers reduces the thickness of the aluminum, transforming it from a solid block into a thin sheet. This process is carefully controlled to ensure a uniform thickness across the entire sheet, but it's not enough to simply roll the aluminum once. The sheets then undergo a second rolling process known as cold rolling, which refines the thickness even further and creates a smooth, shiny surface. This step is crucial in determining the quality and performance of the aluminum foil. Precision is key throughout this entire process. From the initial casting of the ingots to the final cold rolling, every step is carefully controlled to ensure the production of high-quality foil. The process doesn't just end with rolling. Up next, we'll see how enhancements and coatings are applied. This is where we add the finishing touches that make aluminum foil not only functional, but also durable and resistant to the elements. So stay tuned as we delve deeper into the world of aluminum foil manufacturing. To ensure the foil's integrity during its useful life, it gets a few enhancements. What are these enhancements, you ask? Let's dive in. Firstly, an aluminum oxide coating is applied. This might sound technical, but it's just a fancy way of saying it gets a protective layer. This layer works like a shield, preventing oxidation and corrosion. It's like giving the foil its very own suit of armor. But that's not all. The foil also gets a little help from special lubricants. These are applied to facilitate handling during the manufacturing process. Imagine trying to slide down a dry slide. It's a bit rough, isn't it? Now add a bit of water and you're zipping down smoothly. That's what these lubricants do. They reduce friction between blades and rollers, making the manufacturing process smoother and more efficient. Now that we've got our enhanced and coated aluminum sheets, it's time to transform them into the foil we're familiar with. The final steps in the production of aluminum foil involve stretching and thinning. This is where the magic really happens, transforming our coated and lubricated aluminum sheets into the thin, flexible marvel that is aluminum foil. Special rollers play the lead role in this act, skillfully stretching and thinning the sheets to a fraction of their original thickness. The process doesn't stop there though. Once the sheets reach the desired thinness, they undergo precise cutting. This stage is crucial as it determines the final dimensions of the foil. Whether it's a small roll for your kitchen or a large industrial size sheet, precision is key. After cutting, the foil is carefully packed to ensure it retains its quality. This involves packaging it in a way that safeguards its thin, flexible nature, while also protecting it from any potential damage during transit. And just like that, our aluminum foil is ready to be packed and shipped. But how is it packaged and distributed? Let's take a look. The final step in the journey of aluminum foil involves packaging and distribution. The packaging process of aluminum foil is a dual-purpose endeavor. On one hand, it's about creating a visually appealing presentation that instills confidence in the product. On the other, it's about ensuring the product's protection, keeping the foil pristine and ready for use. The distribution of aluminum foil is a global operation catering to a variety of customer needs. It can be found in your local supermarket, kitchen supply stores, and even with industrial suppliers. And no matter the destination, security measures are implemented to ensure the foil arrives in optimal condition. From the bauxitization of bauxite to the meticulous rolling process, the creation of aluminum foil is a marvel of modern manufacturing. And with its packaging and distribution, this versatile product reaches kitchens and industries around the world. And that, dear viewers, is the journey of aluminum foil from bauxite to your kitchen. A truly remarkable process, isn't it?